Welcome. In this video, we are learning the general process Drupal goes through to produce the HTML provided to your web browser. In doing so, we will understand where the theming system of Drupal applies in this so-called page callback process. With Drupal, the act of controlling the presentation of your site is called theming. This separates the theming code from the code used to input or manipulate data. Think of it as presentation theming code and business logic code. Programming in this way allows you to update one without affecting the other. The theme system in Drupal allows you to add your custom CSS, JavaScript, and images to create a website that reflect your brand. Drupal also allows you to selectively override HTML and CSS created by Drupal core and contributed modules with your own code when needed. Drupal gives you complete control over the appearance of your Drupal site. Remember that with Drupal, it all starts with data. This data flow diagram was introduced in the site building course, and we are recalling it again here. Let's use a hypothetical example of presenting a product to a user, say some sunglasses. This is a simplified example to help you understand the process. In the database, we have details of our product. For instance, price, product description, and perhaps the location of a product image. How this data got into this first layer here was through Drupal, likely by a content editor, but this data could have also been placed, for example, via a decoupled Drupal application. For our example, how the data got into this database doesn't matter. Okay, so we are in the process of displaying this product of sunglasses to the user. In the next phase here, modules are allowed to interact with the data pulled from the database. Perhaps there is a custom module called Summer Sale, and for one specific week in August, this summer sale module applies a 20% discount to the price. This is where that business logic would apply the discount to the price stored in the database without affecting the database. After allowing modules to interact with the data, here in the blocks and menu phase, Drupal begins to organize all data and prepare it for display. Make a note that the data is not actually displayed at this point. The data is organized into special variables intended to be displayed. These special variables are called render arrays. We'll see those soon in upcoming videos. Next, Drupal applies access checks to various page elements based on user permissions. This phase doesn't much apply to theming. Moving on, finally, we arrive at the presentation layer of the data flow of Drupal. This is where the theming system of Drupal applies, and this is where the learning of this course is relevant. Remember, much of Drupal theming involves overriding the default output of Drupal. Now that we are familiar with the data flow of Drupal, which presents data to the site users, let's gain an understanding of what happens when your visitor's web browser first makes a request for a page. Here is an overview of what happens when a visitor visits a Drupal site. First, the initial request. When Drupal gets a page request, Drupal core undergoes a bootstrap process, which includes communication with the database, reading all required core, contributed, or custom modules to determine what data needs to be retrieved. Keep in mind that the bootstrap process has nothing to do with the bootstrap theme, if you are familiar with that theme. Historically, with now outdated versions of Drupal 7 and previous, index.php was in charge of bootstrapping Drupal to initialize the database, set session variables, and so on. But with Drupal 8 and 9 and modern versions of Drupal, with the introduction of Symfony, Drupal's bootstrap process is vastly different from previous versions of Drupal, and this process is exceedingly improved. if you are interested in going further with how technically Drupal achieves Bootstrap, be sure to check out the Drupal Module Development course within Acquia Academy. In brief, the container running Drupal is cached, and this results in a blazing fast Drupal Bootstrap. When you load your first Drupal page, all the service information that was compiled is saved for quick retrieval. Okay, that context was quite technical. In short, when Drupal receives a request for a page, it automatically begins the data flow of Drupal process. Next, Drupal's core and contributed modules render sections of generated HTML, doing a good bit of front-end work on their own. Once done, it hands its results to the theme layer. The theme layer has the final say in how the data should be presented. This layer can override any HTML already rendered. HTML output. This creates the final HTML markup that gets pushed to your browser. The theme mainly overrides and enhances the way the data is prepared for display, and then adds CSS, JavaScript, and images of its own. Then is browser loading. Based on how your HTML file is structured, your browser will make requests to load the CSS files, JavaScript, and any media files. Once the page has loaded in your browser, your visitor can click a new link and start the whole rendering process again. There is a chain of command in the types of languages used in Drupal. First, there's PHP, then HTML, and any CSS or JavaScript. PHP is processed first, generating HTML. HTML is pushed to the web browser and acted upon by CSS and by JavaScript. Each language or scripting language has its own purpose. With CSS, this is in charge of the look and the layout of the site. HTML provides the markup to indicate the structure of a site and tags elements so CSS and JavaScript can find them and transform them or perform actions on them. JavaScript manipulates, animates, or transforms element on a page. With Twig is the templating engine for Drupal. It has a themer-friendly syntax, and it takes the place of PHP templates of previous versions of Drupal 7 and before. And Twig does this so themers don't need to know PHP. Now, PHP handles the site logic, database connections, and performs data manipulation too complex for JavaScript. Additionally, Twig templates are converted to PHP by the Twig templating engine. It is important to use each language for its intended purpose and to follow the chain of command and not attempt to use, for example, JavaScript to accomplish a CSS task or to use CSS to cover up something that should be handled in markup. Another way to think about it is in terms of each level adding enhancement. The site should still function as the outermost layers are stripped away. If it doesn't function, then the theme was not built correctly. In summary, we learned that with Drupal, the theming or presentation of your site is controlled by code, which is separate from the code in charge of the business logic of your website. We learned that there is a general process that Drupal goes through from data to presentation called the data flow of Drupal. We learned how this data flow of Drupal fits into the broader process of a page request in which the web browser requests and then loads the page. Well done getting through this video. Coming up, we'll begin to construct a simple theme. Happy learning!